Hi, I'm Nigel Hickey, Technical Marketing Architect for the Cloud Platform Business Unit at VMware. Today we're going to talk about changing the fully qualified domain name of your vCenter server. Before we get started, we should talk about a couple of requirements or prerequisites. So this is only supported for the embedded vCenter server appliance. So if you're running the vCenter server for Windows, or you have a vCenter server appliance connected to an external platform services controller, that is not supported. A file-based backup should be taken of the vCenter server that you're changing the name of, as well as all the vCenter servers in that same SSO domain. If you're using vCenter HA or VCHA, we must remove that prior to making any name changes. Also, we should be sure that we have our forward and reverse DNS lookup records available prior to making that change. Be sure to have your SSO admin username and password available, as well as unregister any products that are communicating with the vCenter server prior to that change so we don't have any disruptions. So now let's imagine that we had a Windows for vCenter server that was migrated over to the appliance and we retained the name and we want to change that name. So what do we do? So we have our vCenter server appliance, but it has a leftover name, WinVC01. We want to change that. Well, in vSphere 6.7 Update 3, we now have that capability to make that change by visiting port 5480, which is our VAMI, or our vCenter Appliance Management Interface screen, and making that change to our network settings. And what we will do is when we log in and make that change, we're now changing the name, or the PNID, of that vCenter server. So now we have a proper name, or a name that complies to our naming standards at our company. So we'll call this one VCSA01. And now we have a different name for our vCenter server. But since we've made that change, we have to be conscious that we need to do a couple of steps after the change so that our environment stays the way we like it. So if we are part of Active Directory domain, or that vCenter server is joined to the Active Directory, we will have to rejoin Active Directory. So make sure we rejoin AD. If we had removed vCenter HA, we do have to reconfigure that vCenter HA. So don't forget to set that back up again. If we had any products that we unregistered, we must re-register them afterwards. So make sure that we re-register our products. Also, if you're using custom certificates, those custom certificates would have to be regenerated. And finally, if we're using hybrid linked mode to VMware Cloud on AWS, we must reestablish that connection to the hybrid link mode. After this has been completed, we have now basically finished the naming process of renaming our vCenter server. For more information about renaming your vCenter server, please visit our blog at blogs.vmware.com/vSphere or vSphere Central, which is vSphereCentral.vmware.com. Thank you for watching and have a great day.